today I am going to talk about the SAN-based virtualization and vSAN technology. Okay, then the SAN-based virtualization and vSAN technology, we are going to using two techniques, that is block level storage virtualization and virtual storage area and network technologies. Okay, this is what two techniques we are supposed to use in the SAN-based virtualization. So we will see what is the block level storage virtualization. The block level storage virtualization, okay, it is going to aggregate the storage blocks, or it may be storage devices, okay, by using the logical unit numbers. Okay, whenever the logical unit numbers, okay, it is going to enable the provisioning of virtual storage volumes. That virtual storage volumes, it is going to store the data independently at the physical device. So this is the block level storage virtualization. Here the block level storage virtualization, okay, we are going to use for the virtual virtualization layer, as well as the different heterogeneous storage devices to create the storage pools. See, this is the diagram of the block level storage virtualization. So we are using multiple servers, okay. The multiple servers, they are going to interconnect to the storage pools, okay, which helps for creating the virtual volumes. This virtual volumes, basically it is going to execute with the help of logical unit number. Why? Because whatever the data or whatever the request, it is going to assign the host based on the logical unit number. This with the help of logical unit number, here all the request or all the the client request, okay, it is going to executed at the server. So this is what the block level storage virtualization. Here in the one more point at the block level storage virtualization, we are going to use for the virtualization layer. The virtualization layer, see, this is what the virtualization layer. This virtualization layer, okay, it is the interface between the storage array as well as the server. Okay, for this virtualization layer, okay, it will be under the storage pool. This storage pool, it is going to works, okay, yeah, I told you, it is going to works based on the logical unit number with the different physical storage, okay. So that, okay, it is very helpful for communicate between the physical storage as well as the servers. So this is about the block level storage device. And this is the next one is virtual SAN. Okay, the virtual SAN, okay, we are also called as the virtual fabric. Here all the all the data, okay, it is going to execute based on the fiber channel. Okay, what it will do, the virtual SAN, okay, which is going to enable the communication, okay, among the different groups or it may be different nodes, okay, of the their physical locations. And the virtual SAN, okay, it is also a group of the senders, or it may be storage ports, to communicate with each other by using the virtual topology. This virtual topology, it is going to defines the physical storage network. And the virtual SAN, okay, we are going to use for the multiple virtual storage area network. Okay, it is going to create the single physical storage in the block level. Okay, what we see, okay, we are going to use for storage storage device will be heterogeneous, means multiple storage devices, okay, which is going to created our storage pool. Because here different or multiple data, they can send the data into the storage pool. By using the multiple servers, it is going to handle the multiple storage arrays. But in the virtual SAN, okay, it is not like that. Here all the data or all the like all the request they are going to handle with the group of nodes, so that we required only one physical device. Okay, it is enough to execute the many number of requests at the server. And the next one is ICSI. Okay, the ICSI, okay, which is nothing but it is the it is the okay internet system. Okay, yes, it is the like a internet system, a small computer system interface. Okay, this is this stands for the ICSI. Okay, the ICSI stands for, okay, which is nothing but is the internet small computer system interface. Okay, here like all the protocols, okay, all the protocols or all the data, okay, it is going to executed based on the IP address. Okay, the IP address, okay, which is going to enables the as well as the manages the connections between the host as well as the storage, okay, storage over the internet protocol. Okay, the ICSI encapsulates the okay different commands. Okay, why? Because it is like which is helpful for managing the data in the in the network. And this ICSI commands as well as the data, okay, it is going to transport the it is going to transfer the data by using the TCP/IP protocol. So this is about the ICSI system. See here, you look at this diagram. So this is the ICSI diagram. Here what we will do for here, we are going to use for the server as well as the internet protocol. Okay, network, this is see, this is the IP network, and this is the gateway. Okay, and we are going to use for the different storage, okay, physical storage at the destination site. Okay, basically the host can like send the data, okay, with the help of host bus adapters. I'm repeating, the sender can request the request through the ICSI HBA. Okay, the ICSI HBA, which is nothing but it will be a host bus adapter. The host bus adapter, okay, it is going to request the data to the server. The server, okay, with the help of internet protocol network, okay, with the help of with the help of network, it is going to divide the request. At the destination side, okay, by using the fiber channel port address. The client, okay, it is going to request the data or request the request by using the host bus adapter. The host bus adapter, okay, it is going to send the data by using the internet protocol network. The protocol, okay, which it is going to decide which request it is going to send to destination. So it is going to divide or it is going to partition the request in the two ways. Okay, one request is going to it is going to send to the ICSI gateway as well as the ICSI port. Here the ICSI gateway, okay, it is going to send the request with the help of fiber channel port address. Okay, so through that it is going to send the request at the storage array. But another side, the request it is going to send directly from the internet to storage array by using the ICSI port. For one request, we are going to send, okay, through the ICSI gateway with the help of fiber channel port address. Okay, another request we are going to send to the storage array with the help of ICSI port address. Okay, there we are going to use for the fiber channel port address. Okay, this side we are going to use for the internet port address. So this is what the implementations of the ICSI. Then we are going to use for the different commands, components of the ICSI. The different components of the ICSI will be a host, okay, as well as the destination. So we are going to call it as the target as well as the initiator, and session as well as the connections. Okay, so this is what we supposed to use for the four types of